From my experience, at least 99% of Apple users have no idea how to delete app on Mac the correct way. Simply how to uninstall Mac apps with all the associated files. So I decided to make a video tutorial, show most used and recommended methods, explain why the official methods are bad idea to use, and of course show you the right way how to delete apps on Mac. So let's go! To better understand what's wrong with the official methods, let's first have a look how it works. The official Apple support documentation recommends two ways. First one is opening Launchpad app on your Mac, holding Alt or Option key until apps will start to jiggle, and then just simply click the X or cross to delete it. Problem is, it works only for Apple apps and apps from App Store. What if you wanna delete app which is not from Apple? As you can see, there's no X or cross in circle next to my third-party installed applications. So, this is the useless way. Okay, so second option Apple recommends is to use Finder to delete app on Mac. This is the easiest way. Just open Finder window, locate app you want to delete, and just move it to your trash, or hit Command plus Backspace, and empty the trash. Easy, right? Yeah, but also useless, because this way you will delete only the app from your applications folder. But don't forget, every app on macOS will have its associated support files, which are located in system folders and not just in applications folder. So if you want to delete any app on Mac the correct way, you should uninstall or delete all of its files, not just few of them. Fortunately, it's also super easy to do. Let's have a look. I will show you example on huge app in size, Illustrator, the only app from Adobe I use on this computer. Whole folder is in total 2.64 gigs in size. Remember this number, in a moment you will see why. So if you would just trash this folder as Apple recommends, you would free up 2.64 gigs on your disk. Now have a look at the correct way. Open any Finder window and in top right corner type name of macOS app you want to delete, in my case Illustrator. As you can see, it found 182 items in total on this Mac. But that's still not all the files which belongs to my Illustrator. In top right corner, click on the small plus button. We don't want to limit search for files which match a certain name. We want to list also system files. At default, this option is disabled. To be able to see it, click on the bottom on the other. Search for system and enable it to show in menu. So now in the dropdown, choose system files and change this to R included. Bang! Now, as you can see on the bottom, it listed 400 files instead of just 182 as before. And a lot of those files are located in library folders, application support and so on. So if I calculate size of all these 400 files, it's 4.93 gigabytes. The Illustrator app folder is just 2.64 gigabytes. That means the officially recommended ways by Apple itself how to delete app on Mac are absolutely wrong, because they would keep 2.29 gigabytes of data as leftovers on your disk. So now just move those 400 files to trash and empty the trash. Done. Before you will delete all those files, just make sure some of its system components are not shared with some other apps. You may ask, isn't there some more elegant way? Glad you asked. Yes. There is amazing free application called App Cleaner with support from macOS 10.6 up to currently latest macOS 11 Big Sur. No installer needed, just download the app, unzip the archive and place it to your applications folder. Open the App Cleaner and just drag any application you want to delete on your Mac to the App Cleaner window. Bang! As you can see, it also listed for the various support files hidden in the system folders. Now just on the bottom, click on Remove, empty trash, and you are done. I personally use combination of these two methods. I always compare results from both before deleting any files forever. So, now you know how easy it is to delete apps on your Mac the correct way. If you would need any help with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux or server build, you can join my website membership, link is in this video description. And I will personally help you using video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Make sure you click the subscribe button below, hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below and click also the share button so it can help to more people, and that will in return also help to this channel and help me to produce for you more interesting videos in future. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Take care and see you by my new video or live stream. Bye bye, my Hackintosh friends.